Publishing a book? Want to know the pros and cons of ebook, paperback, hardback, and audiobook? Stick around to find out. Hey all, and welcome to my vlog. My name is Erin, and this is how to choose a book format for your book. Books come in multiple formats, and I'm going to take you through all of them. I have not published under all of them, so while some of this information is bolstered by personal experience, some of it is coming at you purely from research. I'll explain each of the formats and we'll go over the pros and cons. Obviously, this information is going to lean towards self-published authors because I am a self-published author, and if you are traditionally published, these are things you'll have to discuss with your publisher. Choosing formats for your books will depend on your budget, resources, skills, and time. Generally, the more options you have for people to buy, the better, because accessibility is great and people have definite preferences on reading style. But also, the more formats you have, the greater your cost is going to be because your cover and interior are going to need to be formatted to accommodate the different book sizes and page counts. Number one, ebook. Ebooks are digital books that can be read on most devices, such as your computer, your phone, your tablet, or your e-reader. If you can only have one format for your book, the ebook is going to be the biggest bang for your buck. What are the pros of ebooks? Number one, your cover for an ebook is going to be the simplest. You require only the front cover as opposed to also having the spine and the back, which means that it's probably going to cost you a little less. Number two, ebooks have a lower production cost than print books. That means you have the potential for a higher profit margin. An ebook that is $5 is going to get you more profit than a print book that's $10. That's because you don't have to account for the cost of printing and shipping, so more of that profit goes to you. The lower production cost also means that your readers are going to have to pay less, so it's a win-win for everyone. Number three, ebooks are instant access to your work. If someone purchases or pre-orders your book, they are going to have it on their device the second it is available. This also lets your book be more readily available in areas where shipping or other costs might otherwise be prohibitive. Number four, ebooks help books be more accessible. Most devices will let you adjust the font size to make them easier to read, and they probably also have a text-to-speech option. Number five, ebooks are very easy and economical to use for giveaways. There's a lot more flexibility in your pricing, and it is a lot more economically viable to give away an ebook versus giving away a print book for free. What are the cons of ebooks? Number one, they can be pirated. If there's a guaranteed way to screw over a writer, it's to pirate their book. Once a pirated book has been put out into the world, authors can lose huge chunks of income, which means they are way less likely to produce more in the future. Number two, readers don't actually own their ebooks. The fee that you pay is a licensing fee to access that work. It is not an ownership fee. If the retailer that you purchased from goes under or decides they're not going to do ebooks anymore, then you could lose access to that piece. While that is probably unlikely to happen, it's good to know in general anyways. Number three, some people just don't like ebooks. Whatever their personal reasons might be, it can impact your sales. Number two, paperbacks. Paperbacks come in two main varieties, and that is the mass market paperback and the trade paperback. Typically, what I've seen with this is books that are not going to have a hardcover release will first be released as a trade paperback, and then down the line will be released as a mass market paperback. If you opt for that instead of having a hardcover, keep in mind that you will need to reformat your book and cover to accommodate the new size. What are the pros of paperback? Number one, everyone loves a good paperback. They are the economical halfway point between ebooks and hardcovers, and they still give people that sweet, sweet satisfaction of holding an actual book. They look lovely on a shelf, they're transportable, and they let you indulge your inner dragon and increase the size of your hoard in a way that is visible to other people. Number two, they can go on bookstore shelves. If you want your book to be visible to people who only shop in physical bookstores, then you're gonna need a physical copy to put there. Having a digital copy and a physical copy allows you to hit up the people who like either format. What are the cons of paperbacks? Number one, they are more expensive to produce than ebooks. They require a full cover, the front, spine, and back, and the cost of materials and labor for a physical book plus shipping. Number two, if you want to make your paperback reasonably priced for your readers, you're probably going to take a huge hit in profit. It's entirely possible that you could earn less than a dollar for a paperback depending on what the production costs are, and what your selling price is, because people will only pay so much for a paperback copy. Number 3, getting a paperback stocked in stores is not always easy. If your book is not being consistently requested, then you're probably gonna have to look at other alternatives. You may have to take less money to make it more enticing for bookstores to stock it, or you might have to put your book on consignment, which would likely eat up all of your profit potential. Number 3, hardcovers. Hardcovers are the expensive relative of the book world. They're expensive, they're high quality, and they look damn good on a shelf. What are the pros of hardcovers? Number 1, hardcovers are classy books. They're fancy, they're beautiful, people want to have them. They fit a certain aesthetic, and for some people, nothing else will do. Number 2, people are going to expect to pay more for a hardcover, and so depending on your production costs, you have the potential to make a little bit more profit here than you would with a paperback. What are the cons of hardcover? Hardcovers can be expensive as fuck, both to produce and to buy. That makes my last pro also a potential con. If you want to make things remotely affordable for your audience, you're gonna see a lower profit margin. And all of the cons related to paperbacks also apply to hardcovers. Number 4, audiobooks. Audiobooks are your story read aloud by a narrator. They've seen a recent spike in popularity and can be a great investment in your career. What are the pros of audiobooks? Number 1, they can bring your book to life in a whole new auditory experience for your readers. Number 2, audiobooks can increase the accessibility of your work. Not only can they make this a more enjoyable experience for visually impaired readers as opposed to the text-to-speech option, it's also going to make it accessible for people who simply do not have the time to sit down and read. Audiobooks are great for commutes and for people to listen to while they're doing other things. Some people don't read books, they only listen, so if you want to tap into that market, you're gonna have to go for an audiobook. What are the cons of audiobooks? The biggest one that I could think of that is all-encompassing is that audiobooks are not within reach for a lot of indie authors. Audiobooks require a pretty hefty investment. You either need money to pay a narrator up front, or you need to find yourself a recording studio or similar if you intend to do it yourself, or you need to have a pretty snazzy platform in order to entice these narrators into taking a royalty share. All three of those options require an investment of time, money, and resources. So depending on what you've got going on, you'd have to decide if an audiobook is something that is viable for you. Whatever format of book you choose is going to depend on your budget, your skills, your resources, and your time. There are pros and cons to every format, so you have to do your research and choose the one that is best for you and your platform. So that is all I've got for you today. Thank you so much for watching all three of my books, Heart and Soul, Olympian Confessions, Hades and Persephone, and Olympian Confessions, Hera, are on sale right now. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe. If you'd like to be notified as soon as I upload, then ring that bell. All my social media links will be in the description below, and I will see you all next week with another video. Bye!